Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dr. Altaf Khan here with a new topic. Today we will discuss basically the important basic terms which are repeatedly used in the nervous physiology, nervous system, even neuroanatomy. So these are very important things. We felt ke most of our students, especially backbencher students, low IQ students, which have difficulty in understanding nervous system, if they understand these terms and these basic things, there will be help in them to understand whole of neurophysiology. Clear? So we will do one by one discuss that important terms used in nervous system, which is based to understand nervous physiology. In this, first of all, simply we will discuss neuron. Okay, neuron is what? Basically, each human organ is composed of cells, basically, important cells. Some are called parenchymal cells, which are specific to specific organ. Like specific cells responsible for liver function are known as hepatocytes. Special cells responsible for the function of the blood, these are blood cells, simply like red blood cell, white blood cell, and also another platelets. Clear? In the same way, the important cell which are responsible for the function of nervous system. Nervous system means what? Okay, our brain and spinal cord. This is mostly, we said, okay, this is central nervous system. Also we have peripheral nervous system. So central as well as peripheral nervous system, the important parenchymal cells of the brain and spinal cord, these are called as neurons. So neurons are cells of nervous system. Simple. So as hepatocyte, as myocyte, as another cell, these are also cells. Every human body organ, its specific cells are similar in some aspect and different in some aspect from another cells. Like neuron will be different from the hepatocyte, they will be different from the muscle cell. So special feature of neuron, you should know that neuron is not a circular cell like another cell. It have also some pointed processes. Clear? Mostly an elongated single process that is called as axons. Axon is a fiber originate from the cells of the neuron. Axon is most of the time many times longer than the length of the cell body of neuron. Clear? And also it has small other multiple fibers attached with the cell body. These are generally called its receiving end. These are called dendrites. So neurons are different from the other cell such that they have typical things not present in the other cell. Axon will not be present in any other cell. Dendrite will not be present in any other cells. Clear? And organelles are less in number as compared to the other cells. But all the function will occur in neuron as in other cell it is occurring. Another special thing in that neuron, we have a rough endoplasmic reticulum, clear, granular endoplasmic reticulum present in the form of nasal granule. So nasal granule is special organelle present in neuron. Some many function of this cell, but we will not go in detail. Simply, neuron is the basic structural functional unit of nervous system, important parenchymal cell of the nervous system. Clear? So this one neuron. Next, inside the brain, suppose if these are neurons, by their own they cannot do multiple function of nervous system. So they need that they should be supported by another cells. Clear? Supporting cell of neuron, most of you know ki these are known as neuroglial cells or glial cells. Clear? So glial cells are neuroglial cells or this neuroglia. These are the cells which supports neuron, helps neuron in their function. We are not going to tell you what are their name. Generally, these are four in type. We'll discuss in another lecture. Clear? So, neuroglia, what neuroglia? Remember, neuroglia, glial cells, neuroglial cells. These are supporting cells and other than the neuron present in the brain as well as spinal cord. Clear? So, that concept should be clear about the neuroglia. Now, synapse. Repeatedly, you hear this word is a synapse. Suppose this is one neuron, this have one special function, this is its axon, clear? Basically, in nervous system, there are million of neurons, they are communicated with each other. Communication between two neurons, suppose this is a neuron, this have this dendrite, another neuron's axon will come and will communicate with this. This communication, this is called as synapse, clear? Synapse is what? Synapse is communication between two neurons. Now, for what purpose this communication is built? This is built for the function of neuron. So that suppose message come from this neuron message will come and will stimulate the other neuron. So for functional purpose this communication is made. Sometimes this synapse is also called as functional communication between two neurons. Clear this? Now, suppose ke this is neuron number 1, this is neuron number 2, from number 1 message go to number 2, if the message go in such a way that ke from this neuron, when message go, specific ion channel opens, there is movement of ion from this side to this side, mostly that will be sodium. For action, generation of action potential, generation of message in the neuron. So if the channel is opened for the communication, that type of synapse will be called as if this is with the help of electrical activity of the channels. So this is known as electrical synapse. Clear? If another way is ke a neuron is stimulated by another neuron in such a way that ke from one terminal a special chemical substance is released, that chemical substance act upon the other neuron and stimulate the another neuron, that type of synapse will be called as ke message transferred from one neuron to other, but with the help of what? Not electrical signal, not channel, not ions moving, not electrically active ions are moving, but here there is a chemical substance. That chemical substance may be acetylcholine, may be norepinephrine, may be dopamine, clear, may be glycine. So this type of synapse is called as chemical synapse. Clear this? So electrical synapse, chemical synapse, this is two types of communication. Clear? In this, basically, another term may be introduced, another important term along with this synapse, this movement, transport. Anterograde and retrograde transport. This is also very important to understand. Okay, we'll draw a neuron here. Suppose this neuron, there is a separate neuron here. This is a neuron. Sometime this neuron cell body may be in our brain nervous system in the motor area, and its axon may reaches up to our leg portion of spinal cord, means may be in the lumbar region L3. So sometime this axon travel up to the distance of feet, and its cell body is in the brain, and its axon terminal is far away, feet away from its cell body. So sometime we need that ke this portion, this terminal portion, and even this whole axon, there should be transport of some substance from this cell body towards that axon. Clear? this type of transport which is towards the axon, towards periphery, this is known as anterograde transport. What that is called? Anterograde transport. Which substance will be transported? Suppose for the release of the chemical substance at this terminal, we need that case some substance transfer from cell body to here. That substance may be communicator substance, may be raw material for the synthesis of this thing, clear? So this type of transport is known as anterograde transport. Simply opposite transport of this is known as retrograde transport. If things are transported towards the cell body, this is called as retrograde transport. A classic example of retrograde, this transport is called retrograde, means opposite. Classic example of retrograde transport is ke from the peripheral nerve, after the dog bite, sometime a lethal virus known as rabies virus that is transported in peripheral axon and will be traveled in backward direction towards nervous system. In retrograde transport, rabies virus, clear? So means opposite transport towards the nervous system, towards cell body from periphery is known as retrograde, towards periphery is known as anterograde transport, clear? So antero and retrograde, clear? Now axon, we have discussed already this axon. Axon is what? Axon is a fibrous string like substance which originate from the cell body, clear? This is a typical axon. It originate from the cell body and go up to the periphery, clear? It may communicate, most of the time this communicate with the other neuron, and with the other neurons, which portion this communicate, most of the time this makes synapse with the dendrite of the other. Clear this concept? So axon is nerve fiber of the neuron. Origin point of axon, this is called as axon hillock. What is that called? Origination point of axon is known as axon hillock. Axon hillock is the initial point of axon, the point from where axon originate. Clear this point? And after the axon, we will see what is the nerve. Clear? So for understanding the nerve, suppose that we take a nerve. This is a nerve in our nervous system. Suppose this is a sciatic nerve. Largest nerve of the body, sciatic nerve. We take that nerve. If we suppose this is a nerve, this is a sciatic nerve. I cut this like this. So what we will see, if I check like that, I will see the cross section of this. So suppose if this is cut and I enlarge its shadow, we will see this like that. Okay? This is its cut section. What will be the outer boundary? This will be its sheath. If this is a myelinated nerve, that will be myelin sheath. Clear? If not myelinated, that will be simple, its lamina. Clear? And inside the nerve, we will see that multiple fibrous substance. Like if you cut a wire of a computer, you see multiple small copper wire in that. This type of substance, this large nerve. What are these dots? These dots are basically what? Okay, this is cross section. This dot will be present in that light. Clear? These dots are nothing but these are basically individual fibers of the nerve. This nerve is basically composed of hundreds of, even maybe thousands of, maybe million of fibers which are called as nerve fibers. What are these nerve fibers? What do you think? Nerve is made up of individual nerve fiber. Collection of nerve fiber is called nerve. What are nerve fiber? These are nothing but nerve fiber are these axons. axons of many cell body come adhere and they make a nerve known as simply nerve, like sciatic nerve, popliteal nerve, any other nerve, maybe cranial nerve. Clear? So nerve is collection of nerve fiber. So one nerve may be composed of hundreds of thousands of nerve fiber. Nerve fiber is nothing but axon. So that should be clear in your mind. Now, if the nerve is having the myelin sheath over it, so that will be called as myelinated. If the nerve is without the myelin sheath, that will be called as unmyelinated. Clear? Simple concept. So, nerve, you understand. Now, another important concept about you should understand ganglia and nuclei. What are these? We will do that also. Okay. Sometime when we grossly C-cut that spinal cord, clear? So cut section of spinal cord B will be like this. So most of the time centrally it is seen the color is like gray and outside color is white. When histologically we check that white is gray, we see that this is gray because multiple neuronal cell bodies are collected. Clear? And single collection of multiple cell bodies inside the nervous system. Clear? Most of the time that aggregation of these neuronal cell bodies that occur in the brain, this is called as nuclei. Nuclei may be present in the brain, may be present in the spinal cord. So inside the CNS, the collection of cell body, grossly that will be seen gray because multiple cell body will be aggregated here. This is called as nuclei. Nuclei may be present in the brain like basal nuclei, lentiform nucleus, caudate nucleus. They may be present in the spinal cord. Clear? Substantia gelatinosa, these are nuclei. What? These are nuclei. So nuclei is collection of cell body inside the nervous system. Nervous system, central nervous system means brain and spinal cord. Another term, what is that? Ganglia. If collection of cell body occur outside the nervous system, suppose here in the periphery, like what? Ganglia. Which ganglia? Do you know any peripheral ganglia? Pterygopalatine ganglia. Clear? Pterygopalatine ganglia is present outside the spinal cord and that is a ganglia, collection of cell body. So if collection of cell body occurs in the central nervous system, that is called as nuclei. If that occur in the peripheral nervous system outside the brain and spinal cord, that will be called as ganglia. So after ganglia and nuclei, also another important term used in the nervous physiology, that is tract. Clear? So what is tract? Tract is basically, this is single nerve which is composed of multiple axon. In a tract, suppose this is a tract. Tract is the way to carry different information inside the nervous system, central nervous system. Either that way may be from lower towards upside, known as ascending tract, or the information may go from upper brain area into lower ward direction. This will be called as downward tract or descending tract. So tract is what? Tract, if we check the cross section of tract, in that we will see multiple nerves. Clear? So multiple nerves. So in one tract there will be multiple nerves, in one nerve there will be multiple axon. Clear? So collection of this nerves is called as tract. And also related with the tract, another term which is used in spinal cord, case spinal cord have a ways to carry collection of nerve, short nerve fiber in the spinal cord, that is sometimes called as fasciculus.
plural fascicula, single is known as fasciculus, like fasciculus gracilis. So fasciculus is similar to that tract. Okay, that will be collection of different nerves. Clear? We will review that. आज हमने क्या डिस्कस किया? अ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ नर्वस फिजियोलॉजी हमने डिस्कस की. ये रिपीटेडली आते रहते हैं जब आप नर्वस सिस्टम पढ़ते हैं, सुनते हैं उसकी वीडियोस, इनका जिक्र बार बार होता है. तो अगर इन बेस को समझ लें नॉर्मल स्टूडेंट तो ईजीली नर्वस सिस्टम को समझ सकता है. उसमें सबसे पहले हमने आपको बताया कि न्यूरॉन बेसिक स्ट्रक्चरल पैरेन्काइमल यूनिट है, वो सेल है जो रिस्पॉन्सिबल है नर्वस सिस्टम के फंक्शन को, उसको न्यूरॉन कहते हैं. दूसरी सेल से थोड़ा सा डिफरेंट होता है, लंबा होता है उनसे, इससे धागे निकले होते हैं. लंबा धागा जो मोस्टली सिंगल होता है उसको एक्सॉन कहते हैं, छोटे धागे जिनको कहते हैं डेंड्राइट्स. ऑर्गेनिल भी होते हैं उसमें, इंपॉर्टेंटली एक नया ऑर्गेनिल, नया सा नाम निजल ग्रेन्यूल. ये एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम ही है, निजल ग्रेन्यूल अलग से चीज़ नहीं है. फिर हमने बताया कि न्यूरॉन नहीं होते सिर्फ नर्वस सिस्टम में, सपोर्टिंग सेल्स भी होते हैं जो उनको सपोर्ट कर रहे होते हैं, हेल्प कर रहे होते हैं स्ट्रक्चर में, फंक्शन में. उनका नाम है ग्लियल सेल या न्यूरोग्लियल सेल या न्यूरोग्लिया. फिर हमने आपको बताया कि न्यूरॉन आपस में बात करते हैं, एक दूसरे के पास मैसेज पहुँचाते हैं थ्रू इट्स कम्युनिकेशन. इनकी फंक्शनल कम्युनिकेशन को कहते हैं साइनेप्स. दो न्यूरॉन अगर ऐसे साइनेप्स करें कि एक से मैसेज दूसरे में जाए, लेकिन मैसेज जाते वक्त आयन चैनल खोलें, डायरेक्टली एक्शन पोटेंशियल एक से दूसरे में जाए थ्रू ओपनिंग ऑफ आयन चैनल, उसको कहते हैं आयन चैनल साइनेप्स, इलेक्ट्रिकल साइनेप्स. फिर हमने कहा कि अगर एक न्यूरॉन एक केमिकल रिलीज कर रहा है, दूसरे न्यूरॉन पर एक्ट कर रहा है, उसको हम कहेंगे केमिकल साइनेप्स. तो ये दोनों किस्म के साइनेप्स होते हैं, केमिकल साइनेप्स ब्रेन में ज़्यादा होता है. फिर हमने आपको बताया कि एक्सॉन, एक्सॉन, एक्सॉन क्या है? एक्सॉन सिंपली न्यूरॉन से निकला हुआ एक पार्ट है, पेरिफेरल पोर्शन की तरफ जाता है जो न्यूरॉन का मैसेज आगे पहुंचाता है. एक्सॉन इतना भी लंबा हो सकता है कि बाज़ न्यूरॉन है बैट सेल, लार्ज पायरामिडल सेल यहाँ होते हैं और जो है स्पाइनल कार्ड तक उसका एक्सॉन आता है, इतना लंबा होता है एक एक्सॉन. ठीक, अब एग्जॉन मिलके आपस में क्या बनाते हैं? नर्व बनाते हैं. एक नर्व को अगर काटें तो जैसे बास कंप्यूटर की तार को आप काट लेते हैं या ख़राब होती है बाज़ों का, देखते हैं अंदर कई मल्टीपल छोटी छोटी तारें, उसी तरह एक नर्व के अंदर थाउजेंड हंड्रेड ऑफ एग्जॉन होंगे. ठीक, अगर नर्व के ऊपर माइलिन शीत है हम कहेंगे माइलिनेटेड, माइलिन शीत नहीं है हम कहेंगे अनमाइलिनेटेड नर्व. फिर हमने आपको बताया कि कई नर्व मिलके क्या बनाती हैं, दिस, ये हमने कहा ट्रैक बनाती, कई नर्व्स मिलके ट्रैक बनाती. और ट्रैक इंफॉर्मेशन अगर नीचे ला रहा है ब्रेन से हम कहेंगे डिसेंडिंग ट्रैक, अगर ऊपर लेके जा रहा है असेंडिंग ट्रैक. ट्रैक अगर सिर्फ स्पाइनल कार्ड वाले खास ट्रैक होते हैं उसके लिए एक वर्ड फेसिकुलस भी होता है, फेसिकुलस भी कलेक्शन ऑफ नर्व्स है. फिर हमने आपको बताया था कि अगर सेल बॉडी न्यूरॉनल वो एग्रीगेशन है उनकी खास जगह पे ब्रेन के अंदर, उसको हम कहेंगे न्यूक्लियाई, जैसे लेंटिफॉर्म न्यूक्लियस, वो असल में बेसल न्यूक्लियाई है लेकिन नाम पड़ गया गैंग्लिया गलती से. इसी तरह स्पाइनल कार्ड में सबस्टेंशा जिलेटिनोजा वगैरह ये भी न्यूक्लियाई हैं, कलेक्शन ऑफ सेल बॉडी. यही कलेक्शन ऑफ सेल बॉडी ब्रेन या स्पाइनल कार्ड से बाहर होगा, जैसे सिंपैथेटिक गैंग्लिया, टेरिगोपैलेटाइन गैंग्लिया, अदर पैरासिंपैथेटिक गैंग्लिया, उनको हम कहेंगे लव्स गैंग्लिया. ठीक है, सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर टुडेज़ लेक्चर.